Representative Daley, it's a pleasure to sit down with you for the next few minutes and discuss really your legislative priorities for the 2013-2014 legislative session. So thank you for taking the time out of your schedule to join us today.
Oh, thank you for doing this.
Sure. We're going to start off by talking about how your constituents' legislative priorities translate into your work here under the Capitol Dome in Harrisburg. So a lot of their issues translate into some of the work you've already been doing as a state representative.
That's correct. In the Finance Committee, we have been looking at tax cuts and making changes to inheritance taxes. My concern has been that there are not revenues that are being introduced to neutralize the effect of the tax cuts, and that in the long run that hurts funding for education and human services and transportation, which I believe are priorities in my district.
Mm-hmm. One of those key areas that falls under finance is that area of property taxes. This has been a decades-long debate in Harrisburg, property tax reform. What do you see coming from your legislative district in that area? What are you hearing from people?
Well, in our district office, we have quite a number of folks who stop into the office for help with applying for the property tax rebate. So I can see that that's really important to people. And I'm glad that my district office staff are able to help with that. And so the other problem is that with the excellent school districts that we have in our district, if the state funding isn't there to fund the schools, then property taxes go up. And so it's really a difficult situation for folks in my district.
Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about the education realm here in just a minute. That issue really goes hand in hand with the property tax reform debate here as well.
It does. We actually have property tax reform debates coming up. We haven't started on that yet, and I have not seen a program about that, but it is something that I'll be paying a lot of attention to because I know that it really affects people in my district, and I want to be able to represent them correctly. Mm-hmm. I'm hoping that when information starts coming out, we can communicate with them by emails, and then I'm sure that I will be hearing back from them.
Sure, sure. One of the areas you've heard a lot about, too, is that education field, and this is one of your top legislative priorities. Talk about what sort of priorities that you come with to Harrisburg. You're here with over 200 other colleagues that have different education priorities, but what are yours?
Well, I think my big thing was always the sustainable funding for education. I mean, we don't currently have funding mechanisms or formulas that would, I think, help the funding for education overall. I've visited with all of my school districts, and I hear from them that some of them have become specialists in special education, but without a funding formula, people are moving into the district because they're so good at providing special education, and then this really throws them off with their whole ability to fund the whole program. Mm-hmm. So it's a complicated issue, but I think that formulas for the funding would actually really help in establishing something more sustainable.
Sure. Well, the issues we talked about are property tax, even other finance issues, education issues, human service issues for the disabled. You were talking about some of the visits you even took to nursing homes since you've been a state legislator. So that's something that's very high on your priority list as well. One of the things that you're about to do as we're taping this in the next few months is to vote for your first state budget. These issues, I'm sure, will be ones that you're going to pay close attention to as we work closer to that final product.
Absolutely. Because as I've been out in the district and even here in Harrisburg, you have so many people who are coming in with, asking and explaining what their programs are and how they benefit people in the district and in Pennsylvania. And many of them are really concerned with the funding levels that they have. And so, we hear a lot of scare stories about June and how difficult it is, but I know that it's going to be one of the most interesting times that I have in Harrisburg to just be able to pay attention to how things roll out. I mean, we have the governor's budget, and some groups are happy with their funding, but then they come in and say, but if we could just get a little bit more for this or that.
Hoping for some tweaking.
And so as a rank and file, and especially as a freshman, I'm probably not going to have a huge input, but I do have a vote, so I will be paying very close attention to how the negotiations come out.
Sure. And finally, are there any other issues that have come up since you've been a state representative that you've heard from your constituents, that you've gotten feedback from, say, via email, via office visits? Is there anything else, any other issues out there that has seemed to be capturing the attention of your constituents?
I am amazed at how much email I actually get. One of the big issues that I've received emails on both sides are is any legislation regarding gun control. There are more people who are interested in seeing things like background checks, like House Bill 1010, which has currently been introduced, because they believe that at least that's a starting point. But I also have people who don't want to see any kind of legislation because of their Second Amendment rights. I respect the Second Amendment completely, but I do believe that the background checks, which we already have in Pennsylvania, House Bill 1010 just extends them out for long guns, and I think that that is legislation that is reasonable.
Mm-hmm. Sure, and we've seen that issue be at the forefront of the national agenda, so it surely will trickle down to the state level as well, which it already has in the form of constituent attention.
Absolutely. It's been one of the big topics. I get a lot of email, and we do go through all of the email, and we do formulate responses to it, so we do try to get back to people
sure.
where I stand
and
why.
And with that said, we welcome constituents to get in contact with you via email, via phone. Your office information is on your website.
That's correct.
Ways to get in touch with you.
I really appreciate it when people contact me in any of those ways. Email is a really good way. Because then we have a record of it. And we do with the phone calls also, but the emails are just really terrific to be able to understand what people are thinking and to help inform me.
Okay, with that said, Representative Daley, thank you for your time. It's been a pleasure speaking with you.
Thank you so much.